Hello there, gamers, simmers, and pilots. I am the Killer Gamer, and we are back with the tour around the world, or partially around the world, with Sublogic Flight Simulator 2 for the Commodore Amiga, following the same flight paths as the Commodore 64, and afterwards, Microsoft Flight Simulator 3 follows what the Amiga does, so... If you haven't been following the Commodore 64 version, let's talk about where we're at, where we're going, and how we're going to get there. Okay, so we are here at Cleveland Hopkins International, and we're going to be flying across Lake Erie in this direction here, and landing at Willow Run, which is next to Detroit Metro Wayne. So, how are we going to get there? We're going to tune into this VOR right here, Dryer VOR, 113.6. And, well, this is kind of blocking some of the vectors here, but I believe this is what I did on the Commodore 64, is we flew out of that Dryer VOR at a heading of 320, which took us... Just about right where we need it to get lined up with this diagonal runway right there. And if we also tune in Salem here, and I'd say that's 17, 16... at a vector of 160, then when that one centers, we'll know that we're going to be, what I think, like 10 nautical miles from the airport. So, just a little bit of old-fashioned navigation here to give us an idea of not only where we're going, but how far it's going to be. Before we get to the airport. Now, obviously, it would be easier if the VOR was located at the airport itself, but since it's not, got to kind of use a couple of nav aids there to have them intersect so you know where you're going to be and how many miles it's going to be. All right, let's go ahead and get this started. We'll turn the magnetos. Get it started there. Now let's get our VORs tuned in. Dryer was 113.6, which is actually already tuned in to nav 1, but let's tune it into nav 2 instead. And that was going to be a vector of 320, I believe. There we go. And then Salem was 114.3. We were setting that up for a vector of 160. All right, let's go ahead and get going here. I think this runway right here, I think, is a good one to take off from. Small runway, not very wide. Okay, this looks good. I dropped 1 degree of flaps. I was expecting him to hear a sound effect, and there wasn't one. Because there's not supposed to be one. Not on the Amiga version. And we have liftoff. And compared to some of those other runways, that one that we took off from was definitely thin. Say goodbye to Cleveland. And the gear up. Flaps all the way up. Okay, the airport at Willow Run is at 715 degrees. No, 715 feet, sorry. Altitude. I typically like to fly 3,000 feet above that in these old simulators because it doesn't really simulate elevation or anything. Changes of elevation. So we'll level off just before we get to 4,000 feet. And we've got autopilot on this version of Flight Simulator. The first version of Flight Simulator to have an autopilot. Go to the autopilot here. We'll set it to a 1,000 feet. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to continue flying straight. If you're watching, okay, so NAV2, you may have noticed that the Omni bearing indicator has switched off. That means we are now passing the VOR. It should change to FROM here pretty shortly. Then we will intersect that 320 radio and head across Lake Erie over to Detroit. So I'm going to go ahead and leave you folks at the flight so you can sit back, relax, and enjoy the flying, and I will be back with you before we land. All right, I am back here with you. We've got Detroit off here to the right. You can see that. And Detroit Wayne is right there in front of us. And Willow Run will be right after that. Now, when I was flying on the Commodore 64, you can see the city scenery there. It vanished. It disappeared as we were getting closer to Detroit Metro Wayne. It was kind of weird, so I don't know if it's going to do that again on this one. There's the airport off to the left there. So, autopilot off. So I'm trying to turn it off. Okay. Landing gear down. Drop a 1 degree of flaps. At the moment, I can't really tell where the runways are at. We need to get a little closer. Remember what I was telling you about Nav 1? When that needle crosses, gets centered, we'll be about 10 miles from the airport. Somewhere between 5 and 10 miles. Thank you. Actually, no, wait a minute, no, hold on. I'm remembering from what I did on the Commodore 64. So there are two runways. There's one here, and there's one here. So there's a right and left. But there's a diagonal one right here. That's the one we landed on. That was the one that I was going for on the Commodore 64. That's the one we're going to be landing on here. Alright, I brought the flaps down one more degree there. I don't want to really do any more than that. It's okay, I just saw the runway there. It became a little bit more clear. Yeah, I don't want to do it really too much more than that. Because if we go too slow, we're going to stall. We don't want that to happen. Although I might do the flaps one more time. We're still at 80 knots. I'm trying to get it slowed down even more than that. Okay, here we are, folks. We're back in Detroit. We're at Willow Run Airport, kind of parked off to the side there. Well, I hope you enjoyed the flight, and I hope you'll be following me on the next adventure for the Commodore Amiga Sublogic Flight Simulator 2. See you next time. Have a killer awesome day.